Hey guys, Ryan here at Signature Edits, and inside of this Lightroom tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create your very own black Lightroom presets from scratch. So if you are in the mood to learn how to create these, awesome, stay tuned, let's hit that intro. All right guys, so I'm going to show you how to create these presets from scratch. Well, one of these at least, get this rough look. Now, I should note that if you want to grab one of these for free, you can go ahead and grab it in the description link below. The cool thing about these pre-made presets from the Black Preset Pack is that they have custom profiles. So unlike the preset we're going to make today, these ones have a custom preset profile that I've made, and you can see we've got an amount slider, and that really is a awesome way to edit your photos, because then all of these other tools down here, the tone curve, the grading, the everything else remains zeroed out. So you can, on a per image basis, adjust all these little things. So if you're interested in that and you just want to save some time and get some awesome presets that have been tested across hundreds of images, these will definitely do the best. But if you just want to know how to get that black look, let's dive in together. So let's head back over here. I should also say, if you want to grab this image to edit along with me, go ahead and find it in the description again below. You can go ahead, grab it, and we'll edit together. All right, that was a very long intro, but we're starting now. It's gonna be good. I'm gonna start by just making some basic adjustments to this image. I'm gonna grab the contrast, bring it down a little bit, highlights down a little bit, shadows up, whites down. There's no like secret recipe here. I'm just kind of getting it to a basic here's before and here's after. So I'm kind of making it a little more moody, because that's just gonna support the look we're going for overall. You can see here's where we're headed. So we've made it a little bit darker, a little bit moodier, perfect. Now we're going to take our clarity and just raise that a little bit. That's gonna give it that sort of edgy, clean pop. Another kind of interesting thing you can play around with sometimes is if you take the clarity down and the dehaze up, sometimes that'll give you a really interesting look as well. You can see how it's kind of got this sort of soft, but also not out of focus vibe going on. I don't know, whichever you prefer, set it either dehaze up, clarity down, or clarity up. Okay, we can add a little bit of texture, maybe, if you kind of like that look, just a bit. Now we're going to take our vibrance down and our saturation down. Now the saturation is the one that I really want to take a far way down, not all the way to black and white, but somewhere around there maybe. And vibrance doesn't have to go quite that far. Now what's the difference between vibrance and saturation, Ryan? I'm glad you asked, good sir or madame. Vibrance will lower the colors that are not skin tones and adjust those other colors, the blues, the greens, and the yellows, more than it will the oranges and the reds. Whereas saturation adjusts them all equally. If that didn't make sense, watch my full video on this topic, because it's going to make a lot more sense for you and just be helpful to know when you need to use one and when to use the other. But in general, if you want to preserve skin tones, adjust the vibrance. If you want to adjust the skin tones and every other color, adjust the saturation. Okay, so saturation is down. Vibrance, we'll maybe leave it around there-ish. I don't know. And then tone curve, we're just going to add some contrast to this image, just like that. So what I've done is I've made 2 points, one in the highlights, one near the shadows, and I've just brought the highlights and the shadows down, and the whites and the blacks are kind of where they were before. Here's before, and here's after. So we've just added some contrast and darkened things down a bit. That's all, nothing super fancy. And if you want to know how to use this tone curve better, make sure to watch my tone curve video, because then I go very in-depth about how all of that works. Or you can just copy those little points and be done. Now, the main part of the magic of this preset is going to be in the HSL panel. We're going to take the saturation for everything other than skin tones, and we're pretty much going to just say goodbye. Okay, perfect. Now the saturation for the oranges and the reds we can take up a bit. That's going to be our skin tones. Yellows, we can take that down as well. And then luminance, we're going to take the skin tones, which is going to be found in the reds and the oranges and a little bit in the yellows, like that. And we can take these other colors down. Something like that. Okay, we're looking a little dark. You can see we've got that kind of black and white look going on. But it's not black and white. It's still got some pops of color where the oranges and the reds, we've raised the saturation and the luminance. So here's before and here's after. You can see how it really just isolates the color. Has a really awesome, clean, grungy, I don't know. It's a very modern cutting look. I like it a lot. Now, if you want to, you can mess around in your color grading a bit. We could maybe add a little bit of some funky fresh to the sky, maybe a little bit of blue in our midtones or our shadows and our highlights. Or maybe if you want to, you can, I don't really care. I'm just showing you some options. So I don't want to add too much. And if you're wondering how to use this color correction panel, you can definitely check out my tutorial on that or my tutorial on split toning. If your area says split toning instead of color grading, it's because you're using an older version of Lightroom. So don't freak out. It's more or less the same tool, just the color grading has a mid-tones slider added. Okay, so here's before, here's after. You can see we can take this preset, put it onto some different photos. Of course, make sure you don't copy the cropping. So I'm just hitting Command-C. That'll bring up this panel. Hit Copy, and then Command-V on a Mac. I believe on a PC, you'd go Control-C and Control-P. And you can see we're looking pretty good. Maybe bring our whites up a little bit so we just have a bit more pop. But it depends. Do you want to have more of like a moody, sullen vibe, or do you want it to really just pop and have that desaturated look? Depends what you're going for. And you can even make a few variations. So this could be our black and white pop. Once you've got it the way you like, let's just make a new preset. So we're going to go up here. Voila. Create preset. We're going to call it Ryan's Black Pop Preset. Sure. And we're going to select everything here except for white balance and maybe exposure, I don't know. Something like that. Okay, now we can adjust this. We can take our dehaze down maybe, or let's do the opposite. Let's take our clarity down, dehaze up. We're gonna make this kind of a filmy one like that. And then contrast down a little bit, tone curve. I'm gonna grab this point here and just pull it up. It's gonna kind of give us that faded look. I'm gonna do the same thing in the whites. What kind of, what I did there, I made an extra point just by clicking. Make sure you've got the point tone curvy tool selected in the main section. We're gonna click once and then double click on this high point. That's gonna remove it. And now you can see we've just got this straight line going across here. That's clipping all of the whites and bringing them down to a gray. Something like that. So here's before, here's after. We've just added a kind of filmic, moody, what have you vibe. So I'm gonna create a new preset. We'll call this Ryan's Black Moody-ish. That is definitely not a word, but we're gonna roll with it. Preset, okay? Select which group you want it to be in, and voila, you have that preset saved, and you can use it on all of your photos and create absolute magic and wonder. And your Insta feed will be alive with splendor. Okay, so hopefully this tutorial was helpful. If it was, do me a big favor, hit the like button and make sure to subscribe for more great tutorials. If you have a request for some kind of other edit, how to make other presets, please let me know in the description. Let me know in the comments. And once again, if you want to grab this preset pack or just grab a free sample, you can do that in the description link below. All right, peace. See you in the next video. Go create something awesome.